my channel, or welcome if you are new. Thank you so much for watching. Today I am sharing a coffee station, coffee cabinet organization. I made a similar video a couple years ago, so if you are looking for even more inspiration, make sure you check out my description box. So in my kitchen, I have a little coffee station, and the cabinet above I use for all coffee and tea related items. So I'm just gonna be going through decluttering, reorganizing, and sharing with you guys how I organize everything, and hopefully give you guys some ideas and inspiration for your own coffee cabinets. All right, so here is an overview of what my coffee station cabinet is looking like now. Of course, it's really not that bad, but I need to do some reorganizing. I need to declutter some of my mugs. These are all of my mugs outside of Halloween mugs. All of my Halloween mugs I keep somewhere else because I have so many of them. So I just need to like reevaluate what's going on in here. And then I'm gonna just share with you guys some tips and tricks and ways I like to keep it organized in here and give you guys a nice little overview of all that. So let's get started. I'm gonna pull everything out of here and just kind of evaluate. All right, so first thing I'm doing is with the KonMari method, which I usually like to follow, is completely emptying out my cabinet. Just so I can assess everything that I have, I definitely need to declutter a few mugs since space is starting to get pretty tight. And I also just needed to give the shelves a good wipe down. I saw some coffee stains and whatnot on them, so I went ahead and did that as well. And then I decided I wanted to do a little rearranging of the shelves. I wasn't entirely sure how this was gonna work out, but it actually did end up working out. And here's an overview of my excessive amount of mugs. So next, I am just starting to sort everything back in here. Up at the top, I am putting seasonal mugs outside of Halloween, like I said. So we've got Christmas, Valentine's Day, and Easter mugs all up here. On the bottom one, I am putting just regular everyday sort of mugs. Airtight coffee containers. Obviously, I had done a decal on the decaf one, but I didn't do one for the regular coffee. So I went ahead and made another label with my Cricut. And here's an overview of my organized coffee cabinet. All right, you guys, I am all done reorganizing, cleaning, decluttering here. So I'll just give you all a quick little tour of how I organized everything. Starting down here, I have my coffee station, just very simple, neutral right now. It is spring, Easter just passed. So I've got some pink faux tulips, this beautiful chinoiserie print, and this tiny little Easter bunny cloched with an egg. All right, and then in my coffee tea cupboard, I've got the decaf and regular, as you just saw me put the label on the regular one. That's the pitcher I use to refill up my Keurig machine. And then over here are all my regular non-seasonal mugs. So I decluttered three that I decided I can let go of. So all of these fit perfect in here. And these little stacking things are super handy. And then I had no idea how this was gonna work out when I was shifting the shelves around, but it actually worked perfect. So this tiny little skinny shelf, I've got all my different containers of stuff. So I decided to put all my little stevia sugar packets in there. This is all of my K-cups and tea diffusers. This is a Dollar Tree basket, I think. I'm not gonna pull it out, but I've got like cappuccino hot chocolate in there. And then my very large acrylic tea bag organizer. And then up here, I've got this copper basket that's all just full of boxes of tea. And then this is like tea overflow. You guys, I have so much tea because like 5 years ago, I swear it's been that long, I bought an Amazon order of green tea. And I swear it was like 1,000 packs of tea. So I was like up to my ears in tea. So that's why I have so much still. And of course, I put my finger over the microphone on my camera. But anyway, I put all of my seasonal mugs up at the top of the shelf since they're out of season and I don't reach for them. So I've got Christmas, Valentine's Day, and Easter up here. And like I said, I keep all of my Halloween mugs in completely separate storage because I have so many of them. If you guys were inspired, motivated, or enjoyed this video, please don't forget to hit that thumbs up button. Make sure you're subscribed for more home decor and organization videos just like this one. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!